known each other since elementary school, and you can see there's two of us, but there actually used to be three.
His name is Garrett. He spends 3 to 4 hours every night working till 3 to 4 a.m., maybe 2 a.m. on a good day, until one night, June 17, 2017, last year, he collapsed in his bedroom a week before exams.
Now, the doctor said it was heart failure. And in fact, he's hospitalized at this moment and he's lucky to even be alive. Personally, I'd always desired his work ethic, his determination, and his motivation to do what he wants. But he had a strong lack of knowledge and awareness in terms of the long-term effects that sleep deprivation can have on him, and it took a toll on his body.
So my name is Leo Wang, and my colleague, friend, and I, as well as the rest of our team, have noticed the startling lack of awareness of sleep deprivation among youth today. Now, teens are getting less and less sleep by the day, and the reason for this is lack of awareness of the long-term negative impacts of sleep deprivation. For example, usually when teens usually spend that extra hour or two trying to get some work done, okay, they do recognize the short-term effects such as lack of motivation the next day, lack of concentration, but they don't consider, or at least they don't recognize the long-term effects or the long-term damage that is actually posed on your body. So let me direct your attention to this statistic right here. In Canada alone, there are over 100,000 car crashes that are directly caused by sleep deprivation. Now, of these, an estimated 1,500 are lethal. Now, these are 1,500 deaths of fathers, mothers, sisters, brothers, and friends, which could have all been prevented if they had recognized the negative impacts of sleep deprivation.
So how will we address this problem? We're introducing Youmay, a revolutionary app that will analyze a user's sleep data based on both their sleeping habits and initial data configuration. But more importantly, it will sensitize them to the risks that their current sleeping habits pose on them. And what this does is it allows them to become more informed of the long-term effects, not just the short-term ones such as lack of motivation or concentration the next day, but long-term ones.
Now, let's look at our market. So there's a consumer and customer differentiation here. So our consumers are high school students who are able to download this app on the App Store and the Play Store. This app will be free to all users. Now, our customers are health institutes who we will partner with. At the end of every year, we will offer our data to these health institutions.
Next is our business model. As with any company, we need a revenue stream. Firstly is a premium membership. Now, as Leo mentioned, this will be for free on the App Store and the Google Play Store. However, once you delve into the specifics of the application, we will offer a premium membership for only $2.99 a month with a 4-month contract. What this does is it unlocks every single feature that the app has to offer. It provides more accurate, reliable, and up-to-date information on the user's sleeping habits, their potential long-term risks and threats. But more importantly, we will actually send a wristband for every single premium user. The user can then wear this, and it will work directly in conjunction with our application to provide the most accurate data possible, and it will be catered for that specific user. Next is partnering with health institutes, as Leo had mentioned, and we will be partnering with these health institutes, providing them data from our application, and it allows them to enhance the research, learn more about the neurological process when a person is lacking sleep or when a person doesn't get enough sleep, to know the detrimental effects of sleep deprivation.
All right, now let's take a look at consumer validation. So 93% of high school students of the 217 responses that we received said that the app, they would use the app on a daily basis. Now 81% of these students said that they would pay $2.99 a month to access all the premium features of this application.
Now moving on is our advertising. We have three main methods of advertising. First off is social media. Now, our target market is high school students, and we recognize, as all of you do, that high school students use social media on a daily basis, whether it's Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever it may be. We realize that this is an extremely effective and convenient means of communication with our target market. Next up is word of mouth advertising, which is not only reliable, but we don't actually have to put any cost or any money into that. Word of mouth advertising can spread on its own. As we get our name out there, our app will become more and more popular. Lastly, our site advertising, where we will invest money into websites such as banner ads and YouTube ads, stuff like that, in order to get our name more out there and advertise to more and more of our target demographic. So what we need is traction. We need to see how plausible our idea is. Since last week, when we opened a Facebook page, our UMay app Facebook page amassed over 500 likes within 1 week alone. Now, this is essentially showing how much traction our app is getting, how popular it can be. And within 1 week, you can see how astounding this number is and how many people actually want to engage in this app, want this app to be developed. In fact, we received over 50 messages to our page of people wanting more and more information about this app, people wanting to learn more, how it works, and when it will get released.
All right, so let's take an inside look at how this application actually works. So on the left, we have the sign-up slash login screen for the user. So on their initial setup, the user would sign in with their email or password. And basically, they would be prompted with a series of questions where they can input data of their body relative to what the app needs to be able to provide analytical support on a daily basis. So how this would actually work is after they have completed this initial setup, ideally the user should only have to enter the hours of sleep that they receive on a daily basis in order for the app to send them, for example, warnings or graphs of the current status of their body. For example, let's say Fred here has logged in 4 hours of sleep for the past 3 days. Then the app would analyze this data and send him a warning. For example, you are at X percent greater risk of contracting type 2 diabetes, for example. Now, let's take a look of the actual user interface of the app. In the middle, we have the time recorded for when the user actually went to sleep. Around is a blue bar symbolizing the optimal amount of sleep that he or she should receive. Below, we have a graph representing sleep data collected over the past week.
So now our scalability. As with any company, as with any startup company, we want to see how our company is projected to progress in the next couple of years. Now you can see in year one, we expect that our net revenue stream will probably amass to somewhere around approximately $100,000. Now this number is not actually derived out of nowhere. We do have financial statements, but due to logistical concerns, we won't be able to provide them for you. However, if you do still want a full Excel spreadsheet detailing every single number, all the numbers that our financial expert had basically crunched over the past week, we can share that for you after the presentation.
Right. So in the future, we're looking at more investments from crowdfunding, for example. This way, we want to gain more exposure. We're also looking at angel investors and different pitching competitions, such as Pitch It, Make a Pitch, Sage, and Summer Company. We also want to make partnerships with different schools. We can have presenters sensitizing the others of the awareness of sleep deprivation, as well as a YouTube channel where we can have educators make short videos on a generalization of the impacts of sleep deprivation.
So now we'd like to take a moment to thank our team for all the effort and dedication they put into the startup for the past around week or so. And we just like to recognize that we hope to basically use our application as a method to help people like Derek, make sure something like that never happens again to another person. Because we think that with our app, we can change the paradigm regarding sleep and sleep deprivation, and we hope to turn our dream into a reality. Thank you.
Realize that he should have even been aware about this. So how are you going to get people to clearly don't put a focus on getting sleep, to not only use the app, but also to be honest with it about the amount of sleep that we're getting every night.
Well, one thing that's key to note is that, as we mentioned at the very beginning of our presentation, when students want to stay up late, all they think about is, I might fall asleep in class tomorrow, or I'll just take a nap tomorrow, and I'll feel good again. But we realize that this is a pattern that is consistent through high school students. They're consistently staying up late, and the only detrimental effect that they think has on them is just tiredness the next day and lack of concentration. We feel that through our survey even, we realize that sensitizing them to the long-term effects of sleep deprivation, such as the possibility of a higher chance of obesity, a possibility of getting heart failure, a possibility of contracting some kind of coronary disease, stuff like this will sensitize them, will allow them to become more informed and take action on their current sleeping habits and improve them for the better. And that's basically why we believe that our application will succeed far past any of the other sleep applications out there, because the other sleep applications don't really sensitize their users into the downsides and detrimental effects of lack of sleep.